You've probably heard how important it is to recycle. It cuts down on waste and keeps our planet cleaner. But what happens when you recycle something? How does recycling actually work?
Let's find out on today's episode of
Colossal Questions.
It might surprise you to learn, but most recycling centers around the world only accept two types of plastic: polyethylene terephthalate, or PET, and high-density polyethylene, or HDPE. That's right, not all plastics are recyclable. So how do you tell which ones you can recycle and which ones you can't? Look for the recycling symbol on your plastic item. If there's a number 1, it's PET. And if there's a number 2, it's HDPE. There's a total of 7 numbers you can find inside the recycling symbol. So there's lots of different items that can't be recycled at all. Why? Usually because they're made up of more than one type of plastic. And when they're melted down, the mix of plastics contaminate each other. Everything that can't be recycled is sent to the landfill as trash. Plastic that can be recycled is sent to the recycling centers, where they separate PET plastics from HDPE. Then they make sure it's all clean. Anything dirty is usually thrown out. That's why it's important to wash dirty plastic before you recycle it. Once it's all sorted, labels are removed and the plastic is shredded, bound together, and sold to processors who melt those shreds into pellets and use them to make new items. Unfortunately, only about 9% of the plastic we recycle actually makes it all the way through the process. Around 16% gets burned for electricity or heat. And the rest? Well, it ends up in landfills or bodies of water. Not good. Plastic recycling also suffers from the fact that each piece can really only be recycled a few times before the quality gets bad enough that it can no longer be used and just gets thrown out. Glass, on the other hand, can be recycled endlessly by crushing, blending, and melting it together with sand and other ingredients. Even still, only 1/3 of the glass thrown away each year in the US is recycled. Still not great. Metal recycling is sent to scrapyards, where it's separated, crushed, compacted, then melted down into sheets, which is used to make new metal items. Unlike plastic or glass, metal fares much better. Close to 70% of all steel in North America is recycled each year. That's more than paper, plastic, and glass combined. Those recycling numbers are a bit eye-opening, and they might make you wonder, how can we make sure more plastic is actually getting recycled rather than piling up on our land and in our seas? Well, the unfortunate truth is, there's no easy answer. But the most common advice? Reduce, reuse, recycle. Reduce means to cut back on the amount of stuff we use so we're not making so much trash in the first place. Reuse means finding new ways to use old plastic before you throw it out. And recycling, of course, means cleaning and recycling everything you can. So, how does recycling work? Well, as it turns out, not as well as we might have thought. So be mindful, make extra effort, and feel free to recycle your newfound knowledge as much as you want.